Church, friends, praise the Lord that we finally come to another Sabbath, and also the first Sabbath of the last month of December. Praise the Lord that we have the gift of life, and also a wonderful place to worship. What you say? You know, last month we reflect on the spirit of thanksgiving. And, you know, thinking about families getting together and surrounding the numbers and the mounds of food and preparations, it really cheers our hearts, is that right? But now we shift our mindset, looking at the memories and voices of the angels sing song to us. Praise the Lord. I would like to say to you that may these seasons of families and Christmas cheers your heart in spite of the rain, the cold, but there's something warm when we hear the music, when we hear the clitterings of lights, when we hear the singings and colors, and people have the spirit to talk about the birth of Christ. I invite you to join with me as we pray before we look into the message this morning. Father God, we ask you, Lord, this morning, thank you for bringing us this morning in the house of prayer. Thank you, dear Lord, for the word that open and share unto us the truth pertained the life that we have. The grave will not stop us and hold us, but Jesus resurrect. Thank you, Lord, for that truth, that we will be in a new heaven and a new earth. Thank you, dear Lord, that we are come to the season that we will reflect on the life of Christ, the gift of God to the world. Allow us, Lord, to absorb, allow us to look at the promise and the reality of God's being with us. Allow us, Lord, to share. Let the Spirit of the Lord speak for us. Touch our hearts. Move our commitments to serve you. We ask these things in the name of Jesus, our Lord and Savior, we pray. Amen. Thank you, Cliff, for that number. Remind us how significant for us to reflect in this truth about the birth of Christ Jesus, our Lord. I would like to invite you to look at the scripture that is being chosen for our passage of reflections. The book of the Luke chapter 2. Luke chapter 2 will have our message of reflections that will help us look at the narratives and the history and the written word that we cherish so dearly in our hearts as Christians. I would like to read a little bit from verse 10. It's on the screen, but it's something that it will see the context of the message this morning. I entitled Angels Chorus. If you're there with your scripture, would you say amen? Luke chapter 2. I would like to read it for us, even those on the screen, you follow through, because it's a moment of reflections. And verse 10 says, "Then the angel said to them," who's them? The shepherds. "Then the angel said to them, 'Do not be afraid, for behold, I bring you good tidings of great joy, which will be to all people. For there is born in you today, in the city of David, a Savior, who is Christ the Lord. And this will be the signs to you. You will find a babe wrapped in a swaddling clothes, lying in the manger.' And suddenly there was with the angels a multitude of heavenly hosts, praising God and saying, 'Glory to God in the highest, and on earth peace, goodwill toward men.'" Angels chorus, or the voice of angels singing and praising God. I would like to let you know that there's something about music. There's something about the sound and the melody of music. But when we reached the core of our emotion, it's actually immobilize us to the point that we will what? We will confess our sins. There's something about music, the voice and the sound, that when we touch and reach the core of emotions, it can arouse our feelings and our joy to praise be to God, to the one that worthy to be praised. When we come to the seasons, none of us, we will hear the music. We will see our community starts to get into the spirit of Christmas. There are debates about Christmas, the day that Jesus was not born on the 25th. That's a different debate. The reality that Jesus was born, can you say amen? As I meditate on this passage and reflect on a thoughts for us this Sabbath, I don't know about you, but the media gives so much that drives us to the point that we don't want to live in this world. There's so much chaos. But praise be to God, the sound of music and the sound of praises of Christmas, it permeates and surpasses all the negatives and all the troubles of this world. What you say? Joy to the world. You know, we normally go to the routine of decorating our house, you know, buying gifts. Have you ever deeply take time to think about the reality and historical truth behind what we have as a Christian celebrate the birth of the one who became human and become one of us? I have mixed feelings because, you know, people put so much emphasis that the day that Jesus was born was not actually the 25th. Historically, yes, it's not on the 25th because the season tells us. But the reality that Jesus was born, amen, we cannot let go and let that debate drown the truth that Jesus was born on earth. The passage tells us that the angels appears to the shepherds. I ask the questions, why the shepherds? Why are the shepherds? What's so much about the shepherds that the angels, the glory of God, revealed to the shepherds? And they said, do not be afraid. I'm bringing a good tidings to you that in the city of David is born the Christ, the Savior of the world. Go and tell and see what is happening in Jerusalem, in Bethlehem. Go and see it for yourself. I ask the question, why the shepherds? Shepherds don't have a glamorous resume that would arrest the attentions of the world. Shepherds are labeled among the lower class of society, the outcast, the simple citizens, civilians. Why the shepherds? Why the shepherds that the host of heavens, the angels, appears to them, and the sound of music that's permeated into their hearts and moved that to the point that they need to go and see what is about to come to pass. They were a weird group of people traveling over to look for the green pastures for the animals. Richard talks about that horse. What's so about animals that we adore? These are weird people that's going to find a green pastures for the animals. They also calls the nomads, people that will never stable and stay in a society and establish someone better for themselves. These are the drifters of society. Why are the shepherds? And the holy angels reveals to them and said to them, in the house of David is born the King, the Christ, the Saviors of the world. Why? The shepherds received the message and they went. They went to the manger and discovered the boy, the babes born in the manger. I would like to let you know, if it were not for the shepherds, the simplicity of their upbringing and the world look down upon them and their story. Praise be to God, their witness were collaborates and testify with the witness of the Magi, the kings from the east. Can you say amen? If it were not for the Magi, the scholars, they read history, they study science, and they travel in a caravans. It disturbs nations because kings and princes are coming, and they're coming with the questions, where is he to be born, the King of the Jews, if we're not for the Magi and the story of the shepherds? We will say it's only a fake news, what you say. Praise be to God, the story and the narrative and the witness of the shepherd is not a fake news. It's a proven fact of history. Collaborates with the story of the Magi that comes in a caravans. We tell and we study the story of Christmas that only three Magi. Of course, it talks about the three princes and kings of the East. But those princes and kings of the East, there comes with many peoples among them, numbers of reasons, because of security. Another reason is because they were merchants. They were traders. They were rich. They were high class. They deserve respect. The story of the shepherds witnessing the angels' chorus, and the story of the Magi build a case that Jesus was born and prophecy has been fulfilled. What you say? When the Magi arrived to the house of the king, they were guided by the what? By the star. What's that star? Have you ever thought about the star? What's that star that guides the Magi? It was the host of angels. The glory of God revealed to them in a form of stars. But those are the choirs of angels singing, presenting the majestics of God, leading to a very tiny place. A place called Bethlehem. They came because they were guided by the host of angels, the stars. Their hearts were moved. But when they asked the questions to the king, Herod, the Bible tells us, Herod heard that when this Magi asking where was he to be born, it disturbed Herod and all of Jerusalem with him when he had called together the peoples and chief priests, teachers of the law, and he asked them, where is the Messiah to be born? None of them knew of where Jesus was to be born. And they said, somewhere in what? In Bethlehem. My friends, as we reflect on the Christmas, the story of the shepherds received and heard the angels' chorus, the story moves our hearts because it collaborates with the historical narrative of the Magi from the East, came to worship and find where he was born to be king of the Jews. This morning we come and just worship the one who came and what become one of us, was born on the earth to the world. I hope the story of the message that was given to the shepherds and the search of the Magi confirm that this is the best news ever, is to see the story that to find where Jesus was born. May I suggest, submit to you, Jesus can be also born in our hearts and our minds this morning. What you say? Affirming the fact that I believe that Jesus was the fulfillment of prophecy. And we are coming to worship him. This week, we were driving with my wife. We turn on the radio. And there comes a wonderful piece of music. It was sang beautifully and powerfully, Silent Nights. When a piece of music, as Cliff shared with us this morning, it moves us to the core of our hearts and lift our mind, and our mind will imagine and put us right there with the message of the story. As I was listening in the car, I could not escape meditating on the what? On the angels sing. This song, Silent Night, it has a little story. It was written by Joseph Alexander Moore. He's a young priest in 1818. He penned this story, these thoughts, and called Silent Nights. We know we're familiar with the Silent Night, but I would like to read it to you. I don't have the voice to sing it, but just follow along with me. Silent Night, Holy Night. All is calm, all is bright. Round young virgins, mother and a child, holy infants so tender and mild, sleep in heavenly peace, sleep in heavenly peace. The next stanza says, Silent night, holy night. Shepherds quake at the night's glorious streams from heavens afar. Heaven hosts sing hallelujah. Christ the Savior is born. Christ the Savior is born. Holy nights, silent nights. The Son of God's love's pure lights, radiance beams from thy holy face. With the dawn of the redeeming grace, Jesus, Lord, as thy birth. Can you say amen? The story of about the silent nights, written by Joseph Alexander Moore. It's an echo of the song that was sung by the angels. Do you agree? Because he echoed the lines of the angels. In the city of David is born the Christ, the Savior of men. When Joseph Francis, as a young priest, this is the times of the French revolutions. About 1700s moved toward 1800s. The French revolutions changed the course of history. You know that when Napoleon's Bonaparte rise to power in France, he reversed the system called the feudal systems and also remove out of power the nobles. And one piece of history, he also removed the power from the papacy in 1800s. It's a historical fact that the Pope even was taken into France because he refused to let go of his power. So he died in prison in France. I would like to let you know when Joseph Francis Marsh written this book, it was such a silent night because of the political disturbance. It was a difference between Christians and also the secular world. Could it be silent night, holy night, is the only hope for us in the midst of the confusions of our society today? Amen. The only peace that we have is that the bone of the infant's child, sleeping peacefully. Silent night, holy night, shepherd quakes at the sights, glorious stream from heavens afar, heavenly hosts sing hallelujah, Christ the Savior is born, Christ the Savior is born. The song Silent Nights, the context, it reminds us, no matter how clamorous the busy of our society, we can find peace by remembering Christ has born. Christ was born. He's born in your heart. He's born in my heart. My friend, this morning, silent nights. It may be silence because of so many things that affecting you and me in our walk with Christ. But when our hearts touch and move by the message of the angels sing, there's peace. Glory to God. Peace on earth. And goodwill toward men. My friend, this morning I would like to remind you, when the angel said, "Fear not. Behold, I bring you the good tidings of the great joy which shall be to all people." Fear not. We may ask, why should we fear? My friend, when we tell the story, when we testify that Jesus was born, it's a controversial story. It disturbed people. People who do not believe in Christ, because we know the story right from the time of Herod, when he heard the story that Jesus, the Son of God, was to be born, he was able to what? To give the order to destroy the young, the little ones, infants until the 5 years old. The story, Holy Nights, the story that Christ is born, is a controversial story, what you say. It disturbed the hearts of Herod, and he said, "Where is Jesus to be born?" And he tasked the Magi, "Go and look and tell me so I can come and worship him." It was not. It was an attempt to destroy the plan of salvation for you and for me. It's a controversial story. No wonder why the angel said, "Fear not." Because it can be a false alarm. My friend, we live in society today that Christians consider to be, they are heralding a false alarm that disturbs peace on earth. No wonder why the angels say, "Do not fear." It can also be a contradictory way of life. It's a politically incorrect and can be seen as a misinformation. My friend, no wonder why the angel, "Do not fear." Because Christ was born can disturb the mind of those who do not believe in God. As we know, as history tells us, Herod was given the order, the edict, to what? To destroy the young infants. As you come and worship this morning, we celebrate Christmas, but it also is a story that considered to be a misinformation to the hearts and mind of those who do not believe in God. But praise be to God, we hear the angels' chorus. Amen. Holy night. In the house of David is born the Christ, the Savior of the world. Not only do not fear, but the angel said, "Behold, I bring you good tidings, the great joy which shall be to all people." The birth of Christ is a good story. It's a good news. Can you say amen? We shall not be afraid of the world and their perceptions and their threats about Christianity. But we shall glorify God, because throughout all those trials, Jesus was threatened from his very early life of his growing up. And he was threatened all throughout his ministry. And they even crucified him on the cross. But nothing was stopped the way of salvation, because Jesus conquered death. Can you say amen? From his death, from his ministry. And he resurrected and he said, what? "Let not your heart be troubled. Trust in me, trust also in my Father's house." In our many what? Mention, "If not so, I will go and prepare a place. And if I go, I will surely what? Come back. So I can take you. So you and me will be there as well." Say amen. Amen. The angel's courage is remind us to us, shall not be afraid. But it's a good tidings for everyone. My friend, it says, "Unto you is born in the house of David a Savior, which is Christ Jesus the Lord." The chorus, the choir of angels, remind us to us the word of prophecy according to Isaiah has been what? Has been fulfilled. Isaiah chapter 9 verse 6 says, unto us a child is born, unto us the son is given, and the government shall be upon his shoulder, and his name shall be called who? Wonderful Counselor, the Mighty God, the Everlasting Father, the Prince of Peace is he. When the angels declare and reveal the glories of God to the shepherds, it's not because of just a tiny insignificant group of people, but it also, God has a heart for the little ones, for those who the outcasts of society may reach with the good news. The good news Christ has born. And this shall be a sign unto you, you shall find a babe wrapped in a swaddling cloth, lying in the manger. My friend, the angels sing and give glory to God. I would like to submit to you this morning the birth of Christ in the manger is not a misinformation. It's not a politically incorrect. It's a history of faith. It's a history of prophecy being fulfilled. Is born unto us the Son of God. Amen. The Son of God that will take the sin of the world upon himself to bring us back and restore the broken relationship that was lost from the very beginning. As we celebrate the Christmas, as we celebrate the birth of Christ, as we celebrate the history, as we celebrate the development of nations, the Word of God is also an echo of the angel's chorus. Glory be to God. Peace be on earth. Goodwill to be on toward men. May God bless you, and may God be with you, give you that peace, that we will not be afraid, because we have seen God gain victory throughout history, through the life of simple people, and even the life of Christ himself. He was born, he served, he died, and he's resurrected. And he said, I shall come back again, and all things will be made new. May God be the glory as we celebrate the spirit of Christmas, as we love each other and share, demonstrate the tokens of God's love. May that peace be with you. May the name of God be glorified. May the story of salvation be a sound of music that will never be deviated, but move our hearts to say hallelujah. Hallelujah. Praise be to God. What you say. Amen. Father God, bless your people. Thank you for Christ. Thank you for the angels. Thank you for the story of the shepherds. Least among these people. Thank you for the story of the Magi. They were respected. God, you have covered all layers of our society with the story of salvation, peace unto you. May God be the glory. In the name of Jesus, our Savior, we pray. Amen.
Before I call for the offering, I have an announcement. December is a unique month. Not only is it the last month of the year, But the last day of the month, the 31st, is a Sabbath. It is not possible to get offerings processed in this year that are given that day. So that means that December 24, the week before, is the last time that you can give a contribution that will be recorded in this year. So keep that in mind as you make your year-end giving plans. This is part of the service where we give to God. And your gifts today will benefit the local church budget. This time of the year, we reflect on all that He has given to us. Imagine God coming to this world as a human to live among us, living, loving, and giving, even unto death. He continues to give us so much more. You might ask, what can I give to God who owns everything and needs nothing? What would He want from me? To those questions, God would say, love me with all your heart, with all your soul, with all your mind, and with all your strength. One way we can show God how much we love Him is to bring Him tithes and offerings. All of us, as Christ's body, can take part in this act of worship. Our offerings today are for our local church, the place we learn and practice love for God and our community. Thank you in advance for your generous gifts. May God richly bless you today and always. The ushers will receive your tithes and offerings at this time.
Our hymn and then our prayer.
Joy to the world. Let's raise our voices and sing with gusto and joy. Okay, do we have a music?
We have our music.
Okay.
Joy to the world, the Lord is come. Let earth receive her King. Let every heart prepare Him room. And heaven and nature sing, and heaven and nature sing, and heaven and heaven and nature sing. World, the Savior reigns. Let men their songs employ, while fields and floods, while fields and plains, we greet the sounding joy. We greet the sounding joy. We greet, repeat the sounding joy. He rules the world with truth and grace, and makes the nations approve. The glories of His righteousness, and wonders of His love, and wonders of His love, and wonders, wonders of His love.
Joy to the world,
the Lord is come. Let earth
okay.
Father God, joy to the world. The Lord has bones to the world. Father God, even though our voice is not as good as the angels sing, but the heavens echo the melody of love. I pray to you, Lord, that you bless your church, your people. I pray to you, Lord, that you bless their hearts of giving, their tithe and offering. They bring to you as the first fruits of their love. May heavens bring all the blessings upon them. As we start this week, until we meet again, in the name of Jesus Christ, our Lord and Savior, we pray. Amen.